Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. Images from our Hubble Space Telescope show a light echo from the explosive death of a star some 11.4 million light years away, still sweeping through interstellar space 3 years after the explosion. The echoing light, which looks like a ripple expanding on a pond, is caused by light scattering off interstellar dust clouds. It illustrates that space between stars is not a totally empty void. Our Cassini mission is providing insights about the energy powering geologic activity on Saturn's ocean-bearing moon Enceladus. According to a new study, heat from friction in the moon's interior could power hydrothermal activity on Enceladus for billions of years if the moon has a highly porous core. Simulations show, as Enceladus orbits Saturn, rocks in the core may flex and rub together, generating heat. Water from the moon's global ocean percolates into the warm interior where it heats and rises, interacting chemically with rocks in the seafloor and eventually erupting into space from fractures in the frozen surface. Our New Horizons mission is asking you to help nickname the Kuiper Belt object it's set to fly by on New Year's Day in 2019. The small, frozen world, located a billion miles past Pluto, is currently called 2014 MU69. You can suggest a better name by visiting frontierworlds.seti.org before December 1st. The chosen name will be used until after the flyby, when a more formal name is proposed. Astronaut Dick Gordon, the command module pilot on Apollo 12, NASA's second lunar landing mission, passed away on November 6th. The native of Seattle, Washington, became an astronaut in 1963 after a career as a naval aviator. He spent more than 316 hours in space on two missions. In addition to Apollo 12, Gordon was the pilot for the three-day Gemini 11 mission in 1966, on which he performed two spacewalks. Dick Gordon was 88 years old. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.